In our JavaScript interpreter, we used exceptions to implement return statements. Is this bad? Should we be using Python if we have to do this?
While there is a lot of language-level exception handling in the real world, I don't think it's a reason to avoid Python or claim that one language is more dangerous than another. Language-level exception handling is super popular. It actually goes back to Goodenough in 1975, who introduced the replacement model. That is an amazing family name. I wish I had that name. And since then, a number of languages have allowed you to deal with programmer errors and environmental concerns, both of which are often lumped under the category of exceptions, at the language level. And this is actually super handy because the previous approach involves sort of setting and checking global flags, and programmers are very poor at remembering to do that consistently and correctly. Even with language level exception handling, it turns out that programmers make a lot of mistakes. One of my personal hypotheses is that this is because the control flow for exception handling isn't visible. When you're looking at the code, you can tell, oh, control is going to flow down to the next line, or if there's an if statement in Python, it's indented over. But exceptions really represent this sort of non-local jump to somewhere else, and the indenting of the code or the structure of the code may not make it clear. And if you're not aware that code can jump out of one line and go to another, you may forget to reestablish some invariant or close some important file or finalize a data structure by the end. And in fact, even a number of years ago, when I was doing my dissertation on the subject, oh, tragically boring, open source Java programmers tended to make on the order of 800 mistakes per 4 million lines of code related to exception handling alone. And in fact, exception handling is so prominent that if you look at an average program, somewhere between 1 and 5% of the text of that program will literally be catch and finally blocks. That may actually seem low, but typically a catch or a finally block, if it's not just empty, will call some other error handling routine. And in large pieces of software, anywhere between 3 and 46% of the program is transitively reachable through method calls or whatnot from catch and finally blocks. So if you're interested in writing large, robust pieces of software that get deployed in the real world, you will spend quite a bit of time dealing with handling errors. And language level exception handling is, at least for now, much better than the alternative for that sort of thing. Is this a reason to avoid Python? We saw in class that we could use something like exception handling to deal with interpreting JavaScript return statements in our Python JavaScript interpreter. No, I wouldn't avoid Python as a result. In fact, even nominally friendlier languages like Java are potentially worse. You may not be aware of this, but Java actually still has go-tos. Go check it out. You can put in labels and then reuse the break statement if you give it an argument to behave like go-tos. So even though nominally more type-safe, more structured languages are supposed to avoid that sort of thing, in practice, a lot of real-world languages, be they Python or be they Java, have their secret dark corners allowing you to write unstructured spaghetti code. This is nothing particularly bad about Python or particularly bad about JavaScript. It really gets back to this almost philosophical issue that sometimes when you detect an error, you don't have enough time, you don't have enough context to deal with it. That's really the motivation for exception handling. When I'm in the middle of some low-level code that fails to write something to the disk or fails to send something over the network, I don't know if I should retry or not. Depends on the rest of the application semantics. If it's some sort of networked maneuver, maybe I want to sleep for 5 seconds and try again. Or if it's something like voice over IP, like Skype, maybe I don't want to bother. Maybe I'll just wait for the next packet to arrive. I can't know unless I know more about the application semantics. So exceptions allow me to throw that notice of an error up and hopefully someone else who has more information will catch it. That's generic to the experience of programming. It's not particular to any one language. So I wouldn't hold it against Python or Java or even JavaScript.